I'm Vanessa.
And I'm Nick.
And welcome to our wedding special.
It's very special.
Whatever your dreams are, I will make them come true.
Well, we know we want to have a destination wedding. It's 2 months away and we have not done anything.
I still don't have a dress yet.
For what?
For the wedding.
I'm scared to death. I don't have it together.
I thought it would be easier.
Baby!
You like it?
Baby, you're sexy.
Cheers!
Yes.
Oh, thank you.
Gosh.
It's like Disney World here. I love it.
Open your eyes.
No, I don't see it.
Oh my gosh.
Wow. How much does it all cost?
I'm overwhelmed. It's not easy. Why am I so upset?
Oh, no.
It means the world to me that this woman is going to be my wife and the mother of my children.
I didn't think I cried as much.
I don't know you.
I want her to realize whatever dream wedding she has in her head, I want to do everything I can to make that happen because this is her day and I want to make it special for her.
Your parents are delighted that you are marrying this young lady.
I want to bring you here because I wanted to have a moment with you to tell you how much I love you.
I feel like I'm home here. Things are about to get a little naughty.
My first pair of stripper heels. The crotch doesn't come out, but the back has a button and it's bam, bam.
I noticed this shady car, and by that I mean it's a paparazzi. We are getting married with our closest family and friends.
Grass right here.
And we just don't want it to be a circus.
I don't think any of our guests are gonna intentionally run their mouth and call, you know, a tabloid magazine. We're not telling anybody where we're going.
Come on, I can keep a secret, you know that.
I know just the opposite.
This is so much better than the pictures.
Pretty awesome, huh?
It's pretty amazing.
One of the top paparazzis is in the vicinity.
Boats are not an issue.
They can take pictures like they're standing right next to you.
The word is definitely out. That takes away your walk across the bridge.
Oh, I just feel like a clown.
It just feels like a circus.
We made a pact to each other that no matter what happened, nobody's worried. Just go with it. To a good week.
To the best of it.
Filled with friends, family, liquor. Sex.
Marriage, you forgot that one.
It's all leading up to that. We met in Palm Springs at the Miss Teen USA pageant, and we were both hosting. She was a former Miss Teen USA, and I was a former boy band pop singer who performed at a Miss Teen USA pageant. I was in a band called 98 Degrees, but by the time I met Vanessa, I was actually in the middle of my own solo career.
I was hosting TRL on MTV, was a correspondent for Entertainment Tonight, and did a little bit of acting.
Then a couple of years later, I went to an event in New York City. Ironically, later that night, I happened to be out, and who walks in but Vanessa Minnillo, fresh off her first Maxim shoot and Polaroids in hand.
And then I think I was like, oops.
And by the way, can I see that Polaroid of your half-naked body on the cover of Maxim?
And then it just from there on became texting until he asked me to be in his music video. 'Cause I want you and I feel you.
Best pickup line ever.
Ever!
I always wanted to use it. Hey, you want to be in my video? I never did. I held out for the right moment.
Do you remember what I said? I told...
Just to call my agent. Or have...
And a track continuously playing over and over and over. Will you take what's left of me? Will you take what's left of me? Okay! I will! And I did.
When I proposed to Vanessa, I took her to the montage in Orange County and sat by the pool and had drinks. It was a beautiful day. The whole time, I've got the ring in my pocket. Got down on both knees and laid it on her. And she said yes. And then we cried and we celebrated. Yeah, it was beautiful. Now you're stuck with
what's
left of me.
Now I'm stuck with you.
What the hell happened to the tablecloth?
I don't know.
It's like stains on it.
That was 5 years ago, and now we're getting married in about 60 days?
Like 2 months. Like, it's 2 months away, and we have not done anything.
No, we need to get a cake. We need to get my dress. We need to get your tux. We need to plan the shower, the wedding.
And then we need to mortgage a small country so we can pay for the whole thing.
This is clean, right?
Well, it doesn't look like it. So today's kind of the kickoff for our wedding shower weekend. Because we can only do a very small ceremony, not everyone could be there for that. We wanted to do a kind of a Jack and Jill wedding shower and invite all the people to the shower who wouldn't be able to be at the actual wedding. Well, let's just strategically place a bowl on top of it.
Oh my God, it's big too, and it's brown.
We're feeding people for free, they'll be grateful.
I'm so bummed.
What else?
Getting the flowers. Sunday night is the wedding shower, but there's a cocktail party this evening. Just welcome the people who have flown in from out of town, which is so nice and so humbling for us to know that, I mean, flights aren't cheap nowadays. So we just want to spend as much time with them as we can and thank them. I mean, these are dying already.
It's not a sign. Doesn't mean anything. Some may have heard I was married previously. But there was never a moment, even in the darkest days after we split up, that I ever questioned the institution of marriage. That particular marriage just didn't work out. I think the one thing that it does allow you to do is to learn. And hopefully what I took from that experience were those lessons.
Seriously, look how janky that is.
It kind of goes with the stain.
Great.
No turning back now. We've made it official. You know, this weekend is kind of the kickoff of the, hey, here we go.
You say that like you were thinking about turning back, or you're just saying
it. No, I'm simply saying it puts the pressure on us to, you know, kind of finish this
thing
off.
There's no pressure on my end.
No. Fine.
Gosh, this can go. Bear with me, we'll be done in a second, and then we'll come hang out.
Hey, welcome to LA.
Yeah, it's good to be out here.
I would like to be relaxed with a glass of wine, welcoming my guests. But at this point, because everything is happening so quickly, I am so, so far behind.
Okay. Well, please, we're gonna get through these and many more tonight. It's just gonna be a party, starting from tonight all the way through the early hours of Monday morning, I'm sure.
Oh, I love you, babe. You do all three almonds.
You handed me that was almost on the table.
All three of them are almonds.
If you took three containers out and there were three things in that sitting on the table, what would you think?
I will say that Nick knows that I am very OCD, especially when it's party planning. This is where Nick and I clash.
And somehow I'm the idiot.
I didn't say you were an idiot. You said that yourself. I just said I think it's really cute that you did three bowls of almonds.
I didn't hear the word cute, man. Yeah. The word cute didn't enter into that first statement, I don't think.
We both have to get the last word in. We both are very competitive. We both want to win the discussion.
I'm just lucky to get a word in, much less the last word.
My point is proven. Where's Bets?
Other room.
Bets!
We just want to take a quick minute to say, obviously, this is a very important weekend for the two of us, and it makes it so special that all of you made the effort to come and kind of kick it off with us here tonight, so.
We just want to thank you guys, because starting tomorrow, it's madness. We just wanted an intimate time with you all. So thank you for sharing it with us.
Cheers!
B.
Hi!
I'm not supposed to be here.
You look like you're in trouble.
Hi.
Are you moving out? Yeah!
It's all gone!
Today, we're doing a day at the pool for the girls, and then all the guys are teeing off at 12:30 with Nick at the country club.
I haven't seen you this drunk or hungover in a couple years.
This weekend is just gonna be one kind of constant. It's like an IV drip of alcohol. I told myself last night, it's a long weekend, don't overdo it. While my brain listened, my liver did not.
Baby, do you have to drink your sorrows away? My best friend in the whole wide world is Jennifer, and her mom and dad made the trip, which just makes me feel so lucky to have them because my parents couldn't make it and I don't have a sister. My brother I've lost touch with. My mother isn't in my life and so it's my dad and my stepmom. And this weekend I'm not represented, so to speak.
Together we make the perfect girl.
Instead of saying, well, my parents weren't here and my mom isn't in my life, I can actually say, I have the Birminghams. I'm so glad you
care.
Me too.
I am feeling awful. This morning, I'm getting together with the fellas to play a little golf. It's going to be a beautiful day in LA, so I'm sure we'll be yakking it up on the, or yucking it up. Hopefully not yakking it up. on the golf course. So there might be some of that too.
Which Nick Lachey is going to show up today?
My brother's here from Cincinnati. Drew's going to be my best man in the wedding, so awesome that he could be there. Oh boy, it's pathetic. The biggest train wreck on the golf course is usually this train wreck right here. What the hell? I think I'd rather be at the pool with the girls.
Yeah, way to go on a limb there.
I still don't have a dress yet.
You don't?
She does not have a dress.
For what?
For the wedding.
Why?
For what?
Brand just goes for what?
She doesn't have anything big coming up.
No.
Wow. Really?
Yeah. I thought you had one and we're just being coy.
You're very calm about the entire thing.
Not a bridezilla.
No. As much as I would have liked to have seen that, though.
This weekend is great in the fact that I felt like such a bride. But this weekend is also terrifying because it really put me in perspective.
I don't want to leave the house yet.
I want to just curl into a ball and just ask for help, but I'm trying to stay positive and not stress myself out about it. Baby, when did we schedule in your hair and makeup time? Tonight is exciting because we are at the London Hotel in West Hollywood, which is where we're gonna have our wedding shower. So we thought that we would just fully indulge in the weekend, and we ended up getting a suite.
Pretty tense.
Oh, you know what he's gonna suggest? It is good for our
head. If you gave me a
Oh my God! Baby, I'm actually nauseous thinking about
from her vast experience.
It always amazes me that every man, or at least my man's, suggestion to any problem, especially if it's my stress, is to please them. Do you want me to say why we didn't have sex this morning?
It's not a sex conversation, it's just an oral sex conversation.
There are a couple things that Vanessa has held out on me with, much to my frustration.
Did you cut him off?
Cut him off?
Into the wedding.
I haven't been cut in. There's no cutting off.
What?
I've been promised that after we're married, that those things will not be held out any longer.
He's like, on our honeymoon, you better be ready.
You would definitely gag.
I'm actually very much looking forward to the honeymoon. There's gonna be a lot of things going on there that are gonna be pretty exciting, and I'm not just talking about the shrimp cocktail.
In a weird way, I'm foggy today. I don't know if it's just naturally, it's in my nature to always wonder if everyone else is happy and content. Like, I feel guilty people flew out here. I just want everyone to have a good time.
You guys throw the best parties every time you have a party.
The party of the century.
I just worry. I do this all the time. You know, like, even the menu, I'm like, we have to do top shelf because all of our friends would, it just, I start thinking about them more so than actually me and Nick. But on the flip side, it's all for good stuff. It's our wedding shower, you know, we're getting married. So I'm excited.
You ready?
I haven't seen it yet. I want to see it.
Wow.
Oh my gosh. Coming up, as soon as I turn the corner, it's a paparazzi. Nick and I just want to protect the integrity of what we're doing. We just don't want it to be a circus.
You know, we're probably going to extremes here, but I'd rather be safe than sorry.
And later,
we're finally here.
Here we are in paradise.
One of the top paparazzis is in the vicinity.
That walk that was going to happen.
If there's a paparazzi issue, your walk over the bridge and into the ceremony is completely exposed.
My concept is she'll walk under this gorgeous canopy to protect her.
I get the idea. It's just
okay, it feels like a circus.
Like, literally, I'm like, all I need is elephants and still walkers. I mean. I'm shaking.
Dress nice.
You look amazing tonight.
Have you seen a ring?
It is.
Thank you.
Tonight is our Jack and Jill wedding shower. So we're on the rooftop at the London Hotel in West Hollywood, and it's beautiful. We have all of our guests up there, just everyone that means something to us pulled together, and it was just a beautiful, beautiful moment.
I gotta make a speech.
David likes microphones, be careful.
Baby, you look really sexy with a mic.
Check, check, check. Everybody, if I could have your attention just for a quick second. You start to plan your wedding, you know, it's kind of a daunting thing, and you try to think of a wedding song.
And one of our most special songs is from the movie Once.
Oh.
And it's Falling Slowly. Am I right? Let's call Falling Slowly.
It's our most special song. Am I right, babe?
Make sure you get it. Well, what it's all about really is it's about it's never too late. And I'm so thankful that I have her standing here with me today and that that she's gonna spend the rest of her life with me right now. I have a very special presentation of the song that I'd like to give to Vanessa.
Oh.
So if you would.
I thought it'd be a cool surprise tonight if I got one of the groups from the sing-off, an a cappella group called The Backbeats, to come out and sing that song and have it be a moment for Vanessa.
I don't know you, but I want you all the more for that.
To see him get choked up over it was so beautiful and such a great moment, and all of my worries just go out the window because I'm getting married to the man of my dreams and my best friend. It's like, yes, you got the guy.
Take this sinking boat.
It's Vanessa's day, and I want her to realize whatever fantasy, whatever image, whatever dream wedding she has in her head, I want to do everything I can to make that happen because this is her day, and I want to, you know, I want to make it special for her.
Today is the beginning of it, 7-week countdown. And Nick and I are meeting our wedding planner.
Hi!
How are you? And I am so excited because now we can get the ball rolling.
Baby!
Yo!
Sharon's here.
For me, it's like, let's get some flowers and, you know, we'll crack some champagne and we'll get a cake in there and we'll have a party, you know? But I understand, we need a wedding planner, so we ended up going with Sharon Sachs. She's done a lot of high-profile weddings. Specifically, she knows how to handle the added elements of paparazzi and all the stuff that goes with doing celebrity weddings.
I cannot tell you how honored I am to do your wedding.
Oh, thank you.
So let's talk.
Well, the easy thing about us, I think, is that we literally are a clean slate. I mean, we don't have colors, we don't have ideas.
And well, we know we want to have a destination wedding. We know that much.
Like a mini vacation getaway for our family and friends.
Anywhere special you want to go to?
Some place that's actually meant a lot to us over the years is the British Virgin Islands.
Paradise.
What are some of the ways that you go about? I know you've done a lot of celebrity weddings, keeping things kind of under wraps.
I think what we'll do is we'll pull a fireworks permit because planes are not allowed to fly in an airspace.
Interesting.
Does that mean we can also have fireworks?
We'll go and check it all out.
What's the quickest you've turned around a wedding in?
I did Chloe's in 9 days, Chloe and Lamar.
We're good.
So we're
good.
Yeah.
We're good. It's
so we're no challenge at all.
Yeah, right.
It's only, yeah. My God, we're
thank you.
So excited.
We'll
so
see you soon.
Thank you. Today, I'm so excited. I'm going wedding dress shopping, and the first place I'm going to is called Samine Couture, and then the next shop I'm gonna go to is Monique Lhuillier. It's just something special about having someone create something for you from scratch.
Oh my God. Wow. The back, wow.
This is a dress, huh?
This is in the process of getting done, so you see some lines not ready, they're not beaded yet.
I love this on you. But let's see what other options there are.
I wish Jen was here to see it.
Should I go call Jen?
Can you see where she is?
Yes.
Where's Jen? I feel like I got stood up at the altar. I've had to put a lot of pressure on my best friend, Jen, who's my matron of honor. And I feel bad. She's having to be my best friend, my sister, and my mom, and my matron of honor.
Oh my God.
For our first day of fittings to be running late as the matron of honor, I felt horrible.
See, look at your butt.
That's exactly what I said.
It looks amazing.
What I didn't understand is that when you custom make a couture gown, you come in for a ton of fittings.
I'm trying so hard to visualize it, I can't. just by watching Vanessa, I could tell it was a little bit frustrating for her, just holding up lace and being pinned in some lace and then talking about what this lace would look like or that lace would look like, if she even likes lace, sparkly stuff, where the waistline's gonna start, where it's gonna stop.
I am trying on these beautiful fabrics and she is so talented and I'm completely in my own head and I'm overwhelmed and I don't know what I want.
So what do you think?
I think it's, we've got a lot to think about. I'm overwhelmed.
Yeah, like, hard. There's a lot of choices.
Easy. It's not easy. Time. It's not easy.
Why am I so upset?
Oh my God.
I know. I just.
Oh,
buddy.
It's okay.
Everyone says, oh, when you go try your dresses on, it's so magical and you know. But the first couple of times, it's frustrating. It's hard. Maybe I could just be completely unconventional and just bring Nick with me.
That's not happening. I'm putting my foot down. So
stop thinking about it.
Let's go. You're going
to
be fine.
I want Nick to just see me and be like, wow. But I don't even know what I want. So I'm feeling like I'm just going to go try something on at Monique Lhuillier because then I'll see it.
Monique Lhuillier, here we come.
I don't want to upset you. I just want to know why you cried.
I guess I feel like... I feel like that's a point when, like, your mom would say, okay, honey, like they have it together.
It hit me like a tidal wave that I'm gonna go through this whole wedding process without my mom. She was my world, and I'm convinced I was her world until I was 8. She said to my father, can you watch her just for a little bit until I get my feet on the ground? And then I didn't hear from her. I've had to build a pretty strong exterior, but the first person that you would think of to talk about your wedding dress is with your mom, and the first person that you want to talk about the wedding location is your mom, and the first person you want to do anything wedding with is your mom.
I don't have it together, and I'm scared to death.
I think you're just stressed right now.
I thought she'd have more of the dress done, and it breaks my heart because she's so amazing. She's so sweet.
It's okay. Samin will totally understand.
I know, but it breaks my heart.
Don't let your heart be broken. Your heart's really going to be broken when you walk down the aisle butt naked because you didn't get a damn dress.
We don't have a lot of time here, and I'm just crossing my fingers and my eyes and my toes that we find the dress right now.
Hi, I'm Megan.
How are you, Vanessa?
Welcome to Monique Lhuillier.
So we walk into Monique Lhuillier, and it is beautiful.
Oh, gosh.
It's like Disney World here.
I love it. Okay.
All right. Can we get this for my bridesmaid's dress?
I'm going to try on dresses and just kind of have that moment as a bride where you try on everything. Poofy dresses and simple dresses, lace dresses, and just see what I feel.
Ready? Gorgeous.
Ready. We have found dress number one. I love that. It really fits her like a glove. Are the clips extra?
That's like the Price is Right.
It's just not the dress.
Brown chicken, brown cow. Skirt comes off.
You're gonna have a lot
tonight. Señorita, cha-cha-cha.
It's just, there you go. You actually have a tail feather.
Good job, Jen. Good.
Thanks, Jen.
I'm your lady in waiting. I love that dress. That's it.
I could
That's
dance.
What you want.
I could eat.
I love this. Oh. I love this.
I don't even know what I like anymore. I'm getting that confused.
She looks awesome in all the dresses, so that was not easy at all.
I don't think you can make a decision right now.
Yeah, there's too many things.
I think you need to sleep on it, digest, and come back fresh. We'll pick three favorites.
And then you come back.
And that's the only thing that you try on.
I feel like I can totally pass out on this
couch. Thank God, me too. Thank you, Megan.
Hey, baby, the tuxes are here.
Daddy's gonna put on a show for us.
I pretend to be excited about a lot of these decisions that happen in the wedding process, but truth be told, the flowers, I'm happy if she's happy. The kind of fork we use, I'm happy if she's happy. The tuxedo, I actually am excited to be a part of picking.
I like watching you play dress up. Come on, sexy boy. Baby!
It was sweet to see him get so into trying on his tux, and Nick looks so handsome.
Oh, dun, dun, dun.
Baby, you're sexy.
You sound so shocked.
Because I never see you like this. Like, you look like
a,
you look like a grown-up. as I'm sitting here in my jeans and t-shirt.
Ooh. Oh, honey.
Is that a good oh, honey, or a
That's a oh, good honey. Oh, honey.
Please.
I love everything about it. That looks so good, though. I like the tie a lot better than the bow tie. Sorry, ladies, this one's taken.
Here I am in one afternoon. You know, I've already decided on my tux, and, you know, she's been to multiple fittings and still has no idea what dress she's gonna wear. So I guess it's good to be a guy.
Wookie, what do you think about Daddy's suit? We're gonna be a family.
I'm gonna make an honest dog out of you, Wookie.
Coming up on Nick and Vanessa's dream wedding.
Ready?
I'm ready.
No way.
I didn't think I'd cry this much.
As soon as I turn the corner, it's a paparazzi.
Oh, wow.
I love you.
I love you.
Okay. I'll be on the plane, but I'll have email, so if you need me, you know, email me or whatever. So this morning I have to leave for a charity event for Big Brothers Big Sisters tomorrow. Love you, baby.
Will do.
I'll call you before I take off.
Love you.
Love you too. You know, it's always nice to give back a little bit, but as it gets closer to the wedding, it's harder and harder to be away from Vanessa.
Let me know when you're taking off.
Okay, baby.
Okay.
It's you and me, kid.
I'm kind of freaking out because we've now picked a date and we have 6 weeks until we walk down that aisle. But I'm excited because I'm going back to Monique Lhuillier and hopefully now I get the right, perfect, beautiful dress.
Monique says, when it's the one, it sings to you.
Really? Okay, wait, I'm closing my eyes, so just come out slowly. Tell me when you're in place.
When?
No way.
Oh my gosh. This is the dress that I'm gonna marry Nick in. This is the dress that we're gonna start our life together in.
Yeah. I think this is my dress!
You put the veil on and you see it, it's magical.
Oh my gosh. It's pretty.
Well, it really is pretty. I didn't think I'd cry this much.
Don't do that.
I'm sorry.
You okay?
Yes. I'm gonna get it up. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Why are you crying? It's the best thing ever.
I didn't think I would be that upset. Why do I wish the one thing that I don't have, which is my mom, to see it? Why?
She's missing out. You have to know that. She's the one missing the boat, not you.
It's been a hard one for me to not have a mom. Just to come out and say, you look so beautiful. My little girl's grown up. Which is why Jennifer is the world to me, because she's definitely my rock.
You do look beautiful.
Thank you. I'm so thankful for you.
God, I'm like this.
Is that inappropriate?
It is absolutely the perfect wedding dress. And Nick is gonna die. Yay. I'm walking out with Jen from the store. I am excited, I am beyond elated, and we were gonna go get a bite to eat, and as soon as I turned the corner,
oh wow,
I noticed this shady car.
Yep.
And by that I mean, it's a paparazzi. When somebody is leaping at you that is 2-3 times as big as you are, and getting in your personal space, I mean, not only is it rude, but it's scary.
Jay. I'm on the street.
Okay, I'll see you there.
Okay, babe.
It's funny to me that they care, because I'd like to think that Nick and I are somewhat boring, but they care. I just don't want the dress to get out before the day.
Dress right here.
Having the paparazzi outside of Monique Lhuillier jumping out of their cars like there's a fire put it in perspective that it's even that much more important now that we keep this wedding location a secret.
So I got in the car and the paparazzi goes, the dress,
it's
in the car, it's right here. I know that we are in this industry and I know that we signed up for certain parts of the media.
but the media is a beast.
I know why we do Twitter, and there are fans in there who are like, oh, we love you, and we love you, Nick, and we love you, and Jen. But then there's other ones that are like, oh, your hair looks like crap today. And I'm like,
yep.
And I continue to read it, you know?
Yeah.
Thick, whatever. I had to block her finally. She compares me to his ex. To address the elephant in the room, yes, you know, coincidentally, at the same time that our wedding is going on, his ex is actually also doing the beautiful thing of getting married herself. And I think that she would probably pray as much as I do that they allow us to have our own moments.
I'll cheers to that.
They build you up to break you down. So when they do break us down, thank God for what we've gone through in the last 5 years that we can handle anything. I'm really looking forward to my bridal lingerie shower.
Look how cute!
It's always nice to get together with the girls to de-stress because you can just let all your inhibitions go.
Go this way?
Hi! Hi.
Do I go this way? Hi. Why are you carrying presents?
Their hostess gift.
Oh, come on!
Wow!
Ted, let me open that door for you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Oh my God, you look amazing.
Jen, look how beautiful. That's fine.
Hi.
That looks so beautiful.
Do you like it?
Jen has knocked it out of the park.
I sent Nick a picture on my way here in the dress, and I said I'm heading to my shower to go pick you up some dirty lingerie.
Yeah.
Wait, this is technically for him.
That's true. That's true.
It was nice to have just girls, have it super feminine, super girly, super sweet.
We're going to do photos.
Okay. And then we have Matt. Matt is our beautiful gay friend, so definitely he added that flair to the bridal lingerie shower.
I don't think we ever grow up, right?
No, we're gonna be doing this when we're 50.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh, God.
It was perfect. Just to be able to kind of hang out in the yard in this beautiful California summer's eve with my girls was awesome.
That was amazing.
Hey, ladies.
Hey, ladies. Yeah.
Hey, ladies.
I just wanted to thank my little Jan, my little girl, my little green, her favorite color.
Her favorite color.
It's so funny because we've known each other longer than I've known anybody or anything in my life. And I just want you to know, you are my happiness, you are my laughter, you are everything good in my world, and I believe that I'm getting married because of conversations we've had, and I know you've helped bring me and Nick together, so thank you for that. And it's forever, girl.
We gotta start popping out babies.
I love you.
Thank you.
She gives me strength, and it's because of her that I've gotten through a lot of obstacles in my life. Yeah. And it makes me feel lucky that I can call her my best friend, and because not everybody has a Jen in their life.
Now we're gonna go inside and open all Vanessa's lingerie gifts.
Should we go in?
Yeah.
Open some presents?
Let's go do that.
I think things are about to get a little naughty in the living room.
She's gonna be literally the blushing bride.
Coming up on Nick and Vanessa's dream wedding.
Oh my God.
My first pair of stripper heels.
Oh my God.
And later.
Baby, it's here. I'll be Mrs. Vanessa Lachey. What do you think about them apples?
I like them apples.
Okay, you want to start?
Yes. Okay. Tonight is my bridal lingerie shower, and I'm really excited. I know nothing. I just know that I had to give people my bra and panty size, which is weird on an invite.
Is that the Santa Claus?
Oh, my God.
It's Mrs. Lachey.
Right now, I'm getting some beautiful lingerie, some La Perla, some Hanky Panky, some stuff for my wedding night.
Whoa!
Vanessa needs crotch optional.
No, time out. The crotch doesn't come out, but the back has a button and it's bam, bam. It's classy crotchless. Oh my God, my first pair of stripper heels.
I
personally can't imagine packing these heels for our honeymoon. Can you imagine going through the scanner and the guy's like, what are these? It's me.
You have to walk down the aisle soon. Please. Walk, not crutch.
You guys, thank you so much. I love it. Cheers. Yay! I can't wait. Yay!
Don't, please don't fall.
Welcome home, baby.
Missed you, kid.
I missed you more.
What's going on?
Nothing. Just writing the wedding planners about the favors. I'm sure that's exactly what you want to do, is walk in on a trip and talk about wedding stuff.
That was the longest flight ever.
I knew that when he came home, he would be very exhausted. So I thought to step into my wifey role a little sooner and cater to my man.
How was it? How was the shower?
It was good.
You gonna model me something?
I don't know.
Well, come on.
Maybe you have to come find out.
You don't know.
Maybe it's underneath my outfit. Maybe I'll give you a peep show. It's only fair, and I have missed him so much.
This is what they call hard to get, buddy. And I'm all in.
Going once. Going twice.
Love you, baby.
I think I found my track.
Really? So is it the one that you thought you liked and then you decided temporarily you didn't like and were upset about, and now you've come back to like it again, or is this a whole nother dress?
It's a whole nother dress. But, like, I got a little emotional because, like, you know, my mom isn't there to try on dresses with me and give me her 2 cents and tell me her little girl's all grown up and she looks beautiful and she's gonna make a good wife and all those cheesy, horny things that girls think their moms would say to them. Mm-hmm. I didn't think it would affect me as much as it did, and that's all. Still, 20 years later.
Come here.
Now you're gonna meet
me. Come here, come here, come here. Now, I know it'll always be a void, but there's so many people who love you and can't wait to celebrate this moment with you and with us. And
I know, that's why I'm so frustrated that, like, it makes me sad. It's like, why am I never thought I would harp on the one thing that isn't in my life, because I'm very, very optimistic and I'm very realistic, and I look at all the beautiful things I have, you and my dad and Donna and
you,
Jen.
You wouldn't be human if you didn't feel the stuff you're feeling. I love you.
You love me.
I can't imagine not knowing where my mother was. It would be shattering for me, and I think it is for her. No amount of love or understanding or support that comes from your spouse can replace what your mother was or is in your life, and I can't say anything that makes that any easier on her.
Anyways, so when I walked out, of course, paparazzi was there.
At the dress place?
At Monique Lhuillier.
Our worst nightmare is that the tabloids somehow get a hold of this and, you know, there's helicopters and paparazzi around the island. And that's just, for us, that's a nightmare scenario. We really, really don't want that to happen. I don't think any of our guests are going to intentionally run their mouth and call, you know, a tabloid magazine.
I don't think so either.
I'm just afraid it's like one of those things where you're sitting in a nail salon and I can see my mom, you know, or somebody, you know, bragging about, you know, I don't think it comes from a malicious place. I can just see somebody slipping up.
I think Nick's right. In order to not have media, not have paparazzi present, we need to call Sharon Sachs, our wedding planner, to ask her what to do. So we have a curveball for you, Miss Sharon.
What can I help you guys with?
We were just talking about privacy.
Well, the biggest leaks happen from your guest list.
Maybe there's a way that we just don't even tell them.
I think it's kind of fun that if we don't tell them anything, we're probably going to extremes here, but I'd rather be safe than sorry.
I mean, do you think we're going to extremes, Sharon? I just feel like we're not the president of the United States trying to make a private event, but at the same time, we don't want to ruin our wedding, so.
Well, I'm right with you there. Our security team that we have, they are as SWAT team oriented as they come. So they will make sure that you will be as safe and as protected as possible. from paparazzi.
I mean, the last thing I want is for people to feel like there's, you know, there's
they're
Secret
very
Service.
Low-key kind of guys.
Okay.
And they almost look like surfers.
So go on.
Land right in.
What's their kill record?
there's railings. And one is strategic, and the other one worked on the ground in the Mossad. So we've got some good guys for you.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
Yep. I'm feeling pretty good about that.
All right, Sharon. Well, thank you so much.
Have a great day, and if you have any other thoughts, just give me a ring, eh?
Perfect.
Okay.
Thanks,
Sharon.
We just looked at the calendar and we have 4 weeks to go until the big day. So I'm going to the gym to get my butt kicked for my bikini, my dress, and for all this pent-up aggression.
Women are supposed to be dainty, right?
Not here. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Wedding dress.
That's it.
Woo!
Let's get married. Oh my God. I started my vows.
But you didn't finish them?
No. I wanted to see how you made me feel this week.
Well, Vanessa and I have decided to write our own wedding vows for the ceremony, mainly because it just makes it more personal. It makes it more meaningful when the words you're saying to one another come, you know, from your heart.
So I literally Googled writing wedding vows.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a good suggestion. Plan to first talk about how great your fiance is.
Talk about other person.
That would be me.
Can't talk about anybody in the group, in the crowd?
Just me.
All right, talk about what's next?
Us as a couple.
Couple. How and then, great. And then lastly?
Then about what we're vowing to each other.
All right, can we talk about something that's actually interesting? Our honeymoon.
Coming up on Nick and Vanessa's dream wedding.
Open your eyes.
Oh, I don't see it.
It's perfect, and I'm just giddy.
Why don't we just do it here?
And later...
Here we go. Come on.
Our wedding planner is Sharon Sachs. She came over to the house and transformed our backyard into this whole, like, wedding showroom. Step.
Oh, step.
You see it?
Step. Open your eyes.
No, I don't see it.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
It's just beyond any of my wildest expectations. It's perfect. I immediately am transported and am just giddy.
I love this.
This looks amazing. Why don't we just do it here? Well, we are now officially a month before our wedding, and when I think of all the decisions we have to make, it is daunting to say the least. I mean, we haven't decided on much of anything other than where we're having it. We've got very little time and quite a lot to do and decide. So we better get on the ball. I gotta be honest. I'm not crazy about these ball things.
Yeah.
I lost mine a long time ago. Why not take these out?
Balls are gone, baby. This is one option. Big pieces of driftwood with these magnificent orchids of all different colors.
I'm just gonna stand up here and you guys can let me know what you decide later. In fact, I might just go watch a game. And man, I think I speak for most guys out there when we couldn't really care one way or the other if it was a daffodil or a dandelion. I mean, you know, we have to appear interested and we have to kind of be alert and we can't nod off during the meetings, but at the end of the day, it's the bride's decision and frankly, that's what it should be.
Right.
Pretty awesome, right?
Looks great. How much does it all cost?
Not much.
Look how cute, baby.
So that's okay. Where everybody would know where they're
go.
Seated.
Did that side say Vanessa?
Yes.
So every place setting would have a runner go across. Oh, very
right.
Cool.
And then they could take it home. That's really cool. What is...
It's like Stonehenge.
Looks great there. Like, we should leave it here.
You know, a bride only gets her wedding once.
hopefully. And it's important to put the thought and money into making it, you know, a truly special and memorable day.
The best part, Vanessa.
I know.
Nick, the invitation. Okay, let's go.
So here are our mock-ups.
Oh, awesome. Okay.
This was to give you an idea if you want to go a little more blue.
Love that. We want them to, our guests, to feel like they're going somewhere really tropical, really beautiful, right. Because they don't know.
That's right, we're surprising them.
Perfect.
Yum!
You know what I love, actually? This is really cute. We registered for this for our wedding shower, and now we're using it for our wedding cake.
Enough talk.
Ooh, look at that.
Oh, my God.
That is good.
This is the best thing I have ever put in my mouth.
Really? With the innuendos? Love that. Cool this girl off.
We're getting married.
So what else? Is there anything else we need to...
Well, we need to talk about the lanterns.
Oh, the lanterns, that's right.
They have these lanterns that float in the sky, and we thought that'd be really romantic if we did that on our wedding, and it's kind of symbolic as us starting our journey together as a newly married couple. So we got some biodegradable lanterns, which were, like, perfect.
Ready? Is it pulling?
Yeah, it's starting to pull.
It's pulling.
We lit it, and it was so beautiful. And so we released it, and we remember that we aren't on the island surrounded by water. We are up here on a cliff surrounded by brush.
Please don't light the canyon on fire. I'm really nervous right now. I gotta get the binoculars.
At a moment of panic there, I didn't want to be known as the one that started the Great Bel Air Fire of 2011 and burned half of LA down.
Houston, we have a problem. It's smoking.
Don't worry, LA.
It's all safe here.
Fire department, it's all safe, but...
All's well that ends well.
Yes.
It's called,
Your mom. Mr. Wookie, do you want to come watch us get married?
So now we actually have to call, you know, some of our guests and let them know that...
All of our guests.
No, they have to save the dates. What are you doing July 12th through the 16th?
I don't know. What am I doing July 12th through the 16th?
We're
getting married.
Well, it's about time.
So here's the thing. We just, you know, we're not telling anybody what's going on.
What do you mean you're not letting anyone know what's going on?
We're not telling anybody where we're going. We're just keeping it a secret.
Come on, I can keep a secret. You know that.
I know just the opposite. My mom, God love her, is so supportive and just wants to be in the mix on everything, you know, and just wants to know what's going on. And I can keep a secret. And it's just out of excitement or telling someone, one of her friends or someone at the nail salon or whatever, hey, you know, I'm going to... Just don't even take the chance.
You can't even give me a hint?
Coming up.
Actually going to ask my dad if he'll officiate our ceremony and be the one to marry us.
We would be honored if you would perform the ceremony.
And later...
Bam, bam.
Yeah! Vanessa and I are coming to Cincinnati, which is my hometown, where I'm from, right before the wedding, and it's just a great time to be around family and kind of take a deep breath before you go into the biggest week of your life. We've actually already bought a house there, which is right next to my brother's place.
Sweet!
Nice. For me, this is always home and the place that I've always dreamed of raising my family.
What time are people getting over here tonight, babe?
I told them 6. What did you tell them?
6 was it. So, not much time. You gonna go to the store?
We're gonna have a little pizza party with some of our friends, just get everyone together and let everyone get in the wedding mood, I guess. Feels good to be home.
Home sweet home!
No, they're coming around the corner.
Man in the driveway.
You guys carpool. Come on in.
Say hi, Uncle.
What's up, girly?
Can I get a hug?
For Drew and I, it's kind of our dream scenario. You know, we go back home and raise our kids together in the place that was so influential for us.
Hi, how are you? Hi, Lunskin. I love your outfit.
I think Vanessa fits in great with the Lachey family. Obviously, I'm a little biased, but.
How you doing?
Doing all right.
All right.
Trying to survive the
heat and humidity.
Yeah.
We have a really big thing we have to do, which is...
actually going to ask my dad if he'll officiate our ceremony and be the one to marry us. Obviously, I'm hopeful he'll say yeah. At the risk of being overly dramatic and bringing you up to the to the overlook, I just wanted to sneak away for a second because there's something I'm to ask, and I think it goes without saying at this point how much I admire, you know, you as my father, obviously, but even more so as a man of integrity and honor and someone that I'm proud to say that in many ways I'd love to model my life after.
You're always gracious to share that.
You know, Vanessa and I have been talking a lot and would be honored if you would perform the ceremony and marry us and kind of set us off on the next chapter of our relationship. Oh. It would mean a lot to both of us, and I speak for her 100% when I ask you this.
It'd be my honor. That'd be wonderful. What a privilege. But
I don't know what I was gonna do if you said no.
No.
It's special to me that he's agreed to, you know, to be the one to marry us. That's going to be one of the more special, you know, parts of this whole experience.
I'm the top of the world. How many opportunities does a man have to share things with his grown son and hear one of the key moments of his life, and I'll be a part of it? You know, your parents are delighted that you are marrying this young lady. Not to pressure you or Vanessa, but, you know, we're kind of looking forward to some more grandkids.
Well, that's a good thing. These kids need some cousins. You know?
Yeah.
You know, everything in its right time, and it's definitely its right time, so.
Love you, dude.
Love you. All right, pressure's off. I feel like I was proposing again for the first time. I got to get down on one knee.
Good job, baby girl. One, two, three. Yay! So I heard the good news.
Great news for me. I am so blessed to be asked to be a part of that ceremony.
We're blessed to have you marry us. Thank you. Thank you so much.
God bless.
I couldn't think of anybody more special or more perfect to do this than his father, because he's been such a positive influence in Nick's life as well as in our relationship. Are you gonna have jokes?
Marriage is not funny. No laughing, Matt.
I'm excited. This will be amazing. I think it's gonna be a beautiful moment to know forever that Dad Lachey married us.
I'm bringing Vanessa to First Presbyterian Church here in Cincinnati because this church specifically means a lot to my family. And even though Vanessa and I aren't getting married there, it holds a very special place in my heart. After you.
Oh, wow. This is beautiful.
It's pretty, huh? I don't remember being this big.
As I walk into this church, I'm transported to that moment for us, and I see us actually getting married. It's like it was meant to be.
So I wanted to bring you here because it's a special place in the history of my family. My great-grandfather was a pastor here, and my mom and dad got married here, and Drew and Leah got married here. Aww. I guess I kind of wanted to bring you here because I wanted to have a moment with you in this place to tell you how much I love you and how excited I am to make this jump with you.
Thank you for bringing me here. I don't have a church that my family all got married in and a hometown, and I feel like I'm home here, you know? And it feels right, it feels real, it's good. And I'm glad to be your wife.
It is real.
I know.
And being in here makes it very real. I'm admittedly a very emotional person. It's very meaningful to me to see how full of excitement and joy she is for everything that's going on right now and everything that's about to happen. So that means a lot to me.
I love you.
I love you.
I now pronounce you.
Mm-mm.
I can't do it. I'm not ordained.
Can't do it.
Did you tell your parents and your family that we were coming here?
Nope. This is just for you and me.
Thanks, baby.
We're getting married.
Ready or not, here we come.
I'm ready.
Me too.
Coming up on Nick and Vanessa's dream wedding. In comes this fairy with all of our family and friends. Let the games begin. And later,
one of the paparazzis is in the vicinity.
They can take pictures like they're standing right next to you.
Oh, boy.
Do you have the rings? You don't have the ring.
Hold on.
This is it. We are heading out to go get married.
Gone. Out the door.
So we've been keeping this whole thing a secret for the last 2 months, but now we're finally ready for our big reveal. We're getting married at Necker Island, Sir Richard Branson's private island in the Caribbean. It's unbelievable.
You do so much planning and you do so much preparation, and to actually land on the island, it's surreal.
Hi. Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to Necker.
How are you?
Hi. It's a magical place, you know? You feel like you're in the middle of paradise, and you really are.
Nick and I would come visit Virgin Gorda. We came every year, and when we drove past this place, they said that's Necker Island, and we just looked at each other, and Nick goes, wedding destination? I'm like, oh, yes, like, yes, it's a perfect wedding destination. We, like, have to get married here. We're here.
Cheers.
We flew down privately with my best man, my best friend, my brother, and his wife, Leah, and everything's just perfectly laid out. It couldn't have looked more incredible.
Well done.
This is everything I imagined and then some, and it just took our breath away.
Oh, baby. Oh, so beautiful.
Pretty insane.
Shoes are off, I'm home.
We walk into the master suite, and it's just amazing. The hot tub's already on.
Oh, this is perfect. We saw the bathtub ready to be jumped into, the master bed waiting to be loved in.
Cheers.
Cheers.
To a good week.
To the best week.
Filled with friends, family, liquor, sex. In no
marriage.
Particular order.
Marriage, you forgot that one.
It comes at the end of the week. It's all leading up to that.
This is everything we dreamed of and then some. So we got here, we had a cocktail, we walked around, we had a great moment, and then in comes this fairy with all of our family and friends.
Everyone made their flights, everyone made their connections, everyone had their passports.
Oh my God, Chris is in the water.
Let the games begin.
Just all our friends and family from both Cincinnati and Los Angeles and New York.
This is my dad, Ben.
My dad hasn't been able to be there for any of the wedding stuff. I'm just excited to see him because I haven't really been able to share in any of the wedding bliss with my daddy.
Oh my God. This is like beyond.
Funny that Necker Island is
Necker.
Necker.
When she was a little kid, I used to call her Necker or Necker Necker. And when I walked on this island, that was the first thing I thought.
Necker. Necker. I never thought of that.
You always hope that your daughter's going to meet someone special. And we've known Nick 5 years now, and I couldn't think of a better person for her to marry.
Announcement. Nick and I want to welcome you home to Necker Island.
Welcome. So happy and grateful that you guys are here to share in it with us and be here with us.
What we want to get out of this week is everyone to be a family. Just make yourself at home. Kick your feet up. Order a drink. Go in the kitchen. Make a grilled cheese. Come in our room. You can do whatever you want.
Come in our room?
Come in our room.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Yeah.
Abort, abort, abort. Don't come in our room.
But to a week of happiness and love and life, we cheers to you guys. And thank you for making it happen as well.
Thank you for having us.
We love you.
Sharon Sachs talked to us about some news that a photo agency in L.A. had tipped off people that they knew where the wedding was taking place. They were sending photographers out. If that's really the case, your walk from the kitchen in over the bridge and into the ceremony It's completely exposed, so someone in a boat could get pictures.
Okay.
And obviously that's the thing we're trying to protect. Her suggestion was to do it here.
I do have to be honest, like, I love the idea of having a completely different change of scenery.
Maybe in a perfect world, that would be incredible. That's what we planned, but...
And I'm not gonna lie, deep down in the bottom of my heart, I'm disappointed because I had this vision of me walking over the bridge of Mr. Branson's home, which he doesn't open up to anybody, and he opens it up to us. We would be the first wedding there. Why would you come to Necker Island in the British Virgin Islands to get married in a cocoon?
Sometimes the world's not perfect, and we gotta make adjustments.
The wedding rehearsal is tomorrow, and right now we get to have fun, and everyone gets to really experience Necker Island. So we thought the best icebreaker would be the Wedding Olympics, where it's just games and madness.
1, 2, 3, 15. So the first event in the Beach Olympics was sumo wrestling, where everyone would get put on this, you know, these kind of inflated sumo suits, and so the first two going to battle in the ring are she and I.
When you've got 182 versus 125, and it's a pushing match.
You don't like the heat, you get out the kitchen.
Oh, it's gonna be a long life together.
Out of the ring, stay out of the ring.
Man, it's hot in here.
I think the highlight of the entire Olympics was the relay race.
We're running down the beach, so out to the stick, round it 10 times, out to the trampoline, 2 bounces on the trampoline, and then back and tag your next team member. Right, we ready? Here we go.
You run down the beach to a paddle that's mounted in the beach, and you have to spin 10 times in a circle, which doesn't sound like a lot, but by around spin number 5, I pretty much was ready to fall on the ground.
10, trampoline, come on, go team it, trampoline.
When we started swimming up to the trampoline, there's one ladder. And so I'm like, why would they invent a ladder when you can just jump up on the side of it?
Amy!
And by me doing that, I lost my draw.
You did?
I completely flashed the whole beach. Everyone got a little copper tone butt shot.
Very nice.
It literally came down to 2 guys. And we're sitting on the finish line like, run!
Come on, Justin! Get in here! Oh, was that close?
We won. Fair and square. It's on the tape. Roll the clip!
How nice is this?
This is perfect. Like a perfect end to a perfect day.
So after a grueling day of Beach Olympics, we decided to treat everyone to a very serene and relaxing sunset cruise.
So that was a cool kind of way to wrap up the day.
Does anybody else agree? This is a perfect ending to an amazing day.
Agreed.
Cheers!
Yay!
And it's not over yet! Okay.
He's going over!
Hold on, don't do it yet.
Whoa!
We're having more fun than you and Nick.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, that's cute.
This is more like a honeymoon.
I'm just so happy that everyone else is having such a great time, you know what I mean?
I know exactly what you mean.
We're having a blast.
I'm happy that you're having a good time.
Bye there.
I am. What do you think? I mean, obviously, paparazzi is always a wild card, but it sounds to me like the word is definitely out.
Well, we decided that it's going to be at Richard's house, because...
No, it is. I think we do it at Richard's
Absolutely.
House.
Absolutely.
I just wonder how we do it at Richard's house. So because of the kind of constant threat of paparazzi being in boats around the island, Sharon came to us and gave us 2 choices for the ceremony. One, we could have it where we'd always planned to, which was in Sir Richard Branson's, you know, private living room, and it's a great spot, but it's not very well protected. And number 2, we can move it into the Great House, which is a much more protected spot, but certainly didn't have the ambiance that Sir Richard's house did. So we had a kind of a tough decision to make.
We're solidifying
right.
Richard's house.
Nah, yeah, I think we both agree we don't want to do it at the Great House. Just
loses something there?
We decided we're gonna stick with our original plan because that was our dream. So we're gonna do it.
Baby, it's here. Finally. And it's worth every minute. I'll be Mrs. Vanessa Lachey. What do you think about them apples?
I like them apples.
I can't wait to marry you.
Coming up on Nick and Vanessa's dream wedding.
Is it one boat?
There's two.
It just becomes a bit of a circus.
And later,
she came around the corner and just took my breath away.
Tonight, well, today, it's rehearsal, and then tomorrow we get married. And we decided we're going to stick with our original plan. So we are going to get married in Sir Richard's living room with our family and friends.
So what we need to do here is this will close all this.
Needs to be closed.
Needs to be closed.
Okay.
What we'll do is make sure that we protect our bride by draping the whole house in shears. I need four poles, and I need a cover overhead and a drop on the sides.
All right.
That way, she can still do the walk over the bridge. She'll walk under this gorgeous canopy to protect her.
Couldn't be easier when the other people who are doing it do it.
Nobody is getting a shot of her, whether it's overhead or on the sides.
Hi.
Hi.
So we get to the rehearsal, and Sharon has constructed this makeshift tent that she's, you know, conceptualized that Vanessa will walk under into the ceremony, and it'll shield her from the paparazzi that may or may not be on the water.
It's like the Pope in his little thing. The Pope mobile.
I have a Pope mobile.
And I'm watching this whole thing evolve, and it just didn't feel genuine, and it was just, the whole thing just felt like a circus.
Part of me would rather not just lose the walk altogether than have the walk with all that going on.
Yeah, I just feel like a clown. Like, I feel like
it just feels like a circus moment.
Like, literally, I'm like, all I need is elephants and still walkers. I mean,
forget it. Cut it. It's a wrap.
It's like a giant mango you rode in on. It makes no sense.
Gosh, it's happening. It's rehearsal, and then tomorrow we get married. I haven't had a moment to really take it in.
Count to five. Okay, and Jen, would I love
you? Oh, man, I already feel like I can cry.
Ready or not, when you're up there running through the flow of the ceremony, and when you hear the music and you start to practice your entrance, it gets real.
So you're here, holding one another's hands, looking into each other's eyes, and you've gazed across the tableau of your friends and family. Can you imagine what a motley crew we present? But we all love you, and I'm just gonna say whatever comes to my head. Then I will.
If you go, I'm gonna go.
And then it's just gonna... We were discussing that earlier. Yeah.
I'm sure there'll be plenty of tears tomorrow. Vanessa can't even make it through the rehearsal without crying, so it's gonna be a moist ceremony. There'll be a little tearage. So because my dad is not officially an ordained minister, we're going to have a local clergyman, Pastor Ricketts, marry us as man and wife.
With this ring, I thee wed, I commit myself to thee, and thee alone. Amen. We'll keep it short.
This is smart, because as you can see, we might not get through it if it's short.
Are you crying?
No.
I just won't look at you. I think that's what's happening. I can't look at you.
I'm sorry. It represents how cool it is. Oh, no.
That's what I love about my dad. You know, he speaks from the heart. This is very important to him. He takes it very seriously, and that's the reason I wanted him to do this. And so I couldn't be happier with that. And he cries through the whole thing. So be it.
My body's telling me it's about to happen. You know what I mean? We talked about you doing my makeup for my wedding for 10 years, and it's here.
Finally.
I'm fine. As I started getting ready, I literally realized, like, I'm a bride. I was getting my hair blown out, and I just felt so loved and so pampered.
Okay, I'm gonna hang this. I'm scared to lay it anywhere.
How unique is that?
I love... Oh, my gosh.
Gloriosa.
I love that. Oh, my gosh. I've never seen that.
There's a boat out there.
Is it one boat?
There's two.
We sent out our two to block.
We did.
Okay. Now at this moment, I'm like, all right.
How would you feel if I had security on the other side of the bridge and we'll get you inside so they can't get a shot coming this way?
Okay. Sure.
Okay?
Whatever we have to do.
Okay. And that way you can come across the bridge with your father just the way you planned it. Okay?
Thank you.
Okay.
At this point, I really tried to stop myself and say, don't get ahead of yourself. Breathe. You guys ready to get my dress on? It's in God's hands.
My skirt is taller than your whole body.
Look at this. Literally, it's a foot taller than I am.
It's just truly about the love that Nick and I have. And there's nothing that can ruin this day for me.
About 30 minutes before the wedding and starting to get a little nervous. So yeah, it was great to have, great to have my family there, kind of making it a little bit less of a serious situation.
How do you feel about this? It's okay? I mean, you all right? It's okay?
I don't polish your turd so much.
Man, it's about the effort.
Oh, I'm bidding on my wedding dress. I was stepping into the skirt, and it's definitely something that you feel in your bones, knowing that I'm putting this dress on to walk down the aisle to marry Nick.
Wow.
Yes, let me put the belt on first. Yeah. You got it? This is the trickiest part. Jen, I know that I've said over and over how great of a friend she is, but it really hit me on my wedding day, having my best friend stand there with me.
Hi. Oh my God, okay, hold on.
Okay.
Wow.
She was the best thing that happened to me on my wedding day next to marrying Nick, was just her being there and sharing in everything and helping with everything. She's the best. Right there. When she put the little belt on and I stood in front of the mirror, I'm just like, well, this is it. This is it. This is the moment. We're making it official. We're getting married and I'm gonna be Mrs. Nick Lachey. It is a beautiful, perfect day on Necker Island and it's the day of my wedding. I'm counting down the hours, the minutes, the seconds until I say I do. Sharon and her team completely transformed the Branson House into the best vision of a wedding sanctuary I could have ever imagined. And I was so excited for everyone to see it.
Hey. Pleasure. Well, very nice to meet you.
Let's do it.
All right.
Go get married.
We are.
I'm excited. It's been a long time coming, it feels like. And this is the moment where I just want to kind of get it going and do it. It's the last minute waiting around that's really kind of nerve-wracking.
When I walked in that room before it started, took one look at her, we were just trying to keep from running mascara and sobbing.
I love you.
I don't see myself giving Vanessa away. I see Nick entering into our family.
I'm about to walk over the bridge and marry Nick, and everyone's probably dying of heat stroke, so I have to hurry up and be Mrs. Lachey.
It's such a climactic moment, I think, for a groom. Those very few seconds right before you see her for the first time, and she came around the corner and just took my breath away. There's no words that can describe how beautiful she looked. I just almost couldn't believe that this was really happening.
You're everything. She's all yours.
Thanks, man.
Are we not indeed blessed to be here, overflowing with joy to witness
the holy marriage beginning for Nick and Vanessa.
We see the ladies and gentlemen.
The Bible tells us that a man will leave his father and his mother and be united to his wife. And the two will become one flesh. Your spouse will be ever more deeply drawn to you with passion and a deeper love than ever before. Nick, please love Vanessa as you love yourself. Vanessa, please, please love Nick and respect him, even when he won't deserve it.
As you're facing each other, you have some vows that you have written and you'd like to say at this moment to each other.
Yes.
I'll go first.
Forgive my cheat sheet. I don't want to forget Aaron. Vanessa, on this incredible day, in front of our friends and family, I am blessed and honored to take you as my wife. You are the answer to my every question, the solace to my every worry. When I feel dark, you give me light. When I feel weak, you give me strength. And when I feel strong, you give me the perspective to remain so. I can only hope that I give you half as much as you've given me. I cannot promise you that I'll be a perfect husband, but I can promise you that I will always strive to be. I love you.
To summarize it, he just told her that she's right and he's always wrong.
pretty much.
Thank you. This is the miracle that happens every time to those who really love. The more they give, the more they possess. You are the most generous person that I have ever met, especially with your feelings and with your love. As I stand before you today, in front of our family and our friends, I promise to love you fully, to encourage you, to respect you, and to support you. I am committed to you always and forever as your friend and as your loving wife.
These rings are symbols of your commitment one to the other. And once you put these on, you're shouting loudly to the rest of the world, hey, I belong to someone and someone belong to me. You know, and you're gonna repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
I commit myself.
To thee. And thee alone.
And thee alone.
Amen.
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 With this ring, I thee wed. I commit myself. To thee. And thee alone.
And thee alone.
Amen.
Amen.
Marriage is the coming together of two lives, the merging of two dreams. By the power invested in me, I hereby declare that your husband and wife, sir, you may kiss your wife at this time.
Officially, Mrs. Lachey. It was magical to be there and to feel this aura.
The whole moment was just perfect.
Lean your heads closer together. Oh, that's nice.
So we know there were a couple paparazzi, and we're not really sure if they were able to get a shot off. You know, at the end of the day, we really don't care. You know, it was such an awesome moment, and if they got something, they got something.
Coming up.
You're getting sassy with it now.
Beautiful, baby.
Sweetheart, I ask no more than this. Kiss the rainbow.
Mr. and Mrs. Nick Lachey.
A kiss.
Hey, wow.
In my imagination.
Are you kidding me?
So Nick and I knew that we wanted A Kiss to Build a Dream On as our first dance. So I knew I wanted something special, and Steve Terrell does a beautiful rendition of the song. I decided to surprise him with a performance.
I was shocked. It meant a lot to me that they both went to such great lengths to make it happen. I think it was a very, very cool moment, and certainly one, you know, neither of us will ever forget.
That's awesome.
Love you so much. And I couldn't sing for you, so I got Steve to do it.
I got her for 5 more minutes. Then you get her forever.
Got your number.
You always want to make your dad proud, and you always want their approval. And this moment is no different for me. It made me so happy. So the first dance and the dances with our parents are done. So now it was time for us to let loose and have some fun.
Time for the best man speech.
It's a blessing to be with you guys through this whole journey. There's not a whole lot I can say about my and Nick's relationship. We're in love with each other. As much as I like being your wingman, you got a partner for life now, Vanessa, and you are part of our family. So know that you are always loved, and you always will be loved, not only by him, but by all of us.
We've known each other for half our lives, so 10 years, and I love you so much, and you're so much more than my best friend. You're my sister, and Nick, I cannot thank you enough. Loving her as much as you do. I'm sorry. I know she's in good hands for the rest of her life.
So we can let it. Is this where she had any guidelines on the
list? Are we ready? So everyone, think of your wish in your head.
They're hot.
So we're down on the beach. It's a beautiful night, and we've just lit the paper lantern.
There you go.
Watch your hands!
And what that symbolized for us is that lantern carried the wishes of all of our loved ones who were there into the night sky. Pretty amazing.
It's pretty perfect. They said, it's time to cut the cake. So, you know, I wanted to get out of my wedding dress and change into one that was a little more fun and sexy and sparkly. And so, so I made a sassy change.
Gotta look.
Deeper back. Oh, oh boy.
Whoa! Who's first?
You're first. Stand still. I can't hit a moving target.
Someone to stand behind me and stand with me and love me and enjoy this moment with me. I mean, what girl doesn't dream of fireworks at their wedding? And you definitely gave me fireworks.
Baby,
in my morning.
This is it. It's nothing but fireworks from here on in.
I love you.
Beautiful, baby.